On this video, I will give you a demo on how to use the Google Drive for G Suite. Drive interface sections. Create a new folder or document. Move files or folders. Upload a file or folder. Share a file or folder. Change the sharing permissions. I have divided the Google Drive in the following sections. Google Bar, Actions, Folder Structure, Files. On this section you can find Google or company logo. Here is where you will see either the Google logo or your company's logo if your administrator has set it up for you. Search box. You can make a simple search for documents or files by selecting the type of file you want to look for, or by entering the name of the item here. Or you can make a more complex search by clicking on More Search Tools or clicking on this arrow. Here you can search by type, by owner, by location, by date modified, by item name, by specific words, by share with, and by follow up. When you're ready, just click on the search button. Grid icon. On this button you will find a shortcut of other Google services like Mail or Calendar. Notifications. You can view notifications from a particular Google service like Gmail or Google Plus, even when you don't have it open. Account settings. This button will help you sign out of your account, switch accounts, or manage your account settings. For more information about the Google Bar, you can go to the Help Center article listed in the description. This section contains the New button, where you can create a new folder, file uploads, folder uploads, and create Google documents, docs, sheets, slides, and more. You can see the path of folders where you are located. The View button to change how your files are displayed. The Details button to show more information about the file or folder selected and who had made changes to it. The Settings button to access the Google Drive settings page. Also, when a file or folder is selected, there are some extra icons to show that shows up. Get Shareable Link to share the file or folder to anyone in your domain with who have the link. Share, to share the file or folder to specific people. Remove, to move the file or folder into the trash. Three dots button, to access more actions like move to, rename, or download. On this section you will find your own folder structure. Under My Drive, you will see the folder structures you have created. Share with me, the files and folders shared with you. Recent, the recent files you have modified. Google Photos, if you have uploaded photos from your mobile phone will be here. Starred, the important files you have marked with a star. Trash, the files you deleted within 30 days. On this section you will be able to see all the files and folders you have on your Google Drive. You can open, share, rename, or delete them from here. To create a new folder or document, you just need to click on the New button and select New Folder or type of document you need to create. If you want to create a folder or document inside another folder, you just need to open the folder where you want to create the subfolder or document and create it in there. Another way to create a folder or document is by locating yourself into the folder where you need the new item, and then just right-click on an empty space and select the item you need. To move files or folders, you can do it in two different ways. One, select the files or folders you want to move using the Shift key, then drag and drop them to the folder you want. Or two, do a right click on them, select Move To, and look for the new folder where you need the files or folders to be located. You can upload files or folders in two different ways. Number one, click on the new button or right-click on an empty space and select Upload Files if you want to upload a file, or select Upload a folder if you want to upload a complete folder structure. Number two, you can drag and drop files from your computer directly to the Google Drive web interface. If you encounter issues to drag and drop folders, make sure you are using the latest Chrome browser version. To share a file or folder, you just need to look for the file or folder, do a right click on it, and click on Share. Then enter the email address of the user or users you will share the item with. Select the type of access you will grant, edit, comment, or view only, and then click on Send. If you want to share the file or folder to anyone in your organization that has access to the link, click on Get Shareable Link. The link of the item is automatically copied to your clipboard, so you can send it via email or Hangouts. To change the sharing permissions, you need to look for the file or folder and right-click on it. Then click on Share. Then click on Advanced. On this window, you have the following options. The link to share the file or folder. Who has access to it? Here you can change the type of access to the file or folder by clicking on the Change option. Public on the web. Anyone with the link. Available to anyone in your domain. Available to anyone in your domain if they have the link. With these four options, you can select the type of access the users will have on this option by allowing them to edit, comment, or just view. If you want to share the item to specific people, click on this option, then click on Save. If you already share an item to someone, you can edit the access by clicking on the pencil. You can make someone the new owner, grant edit access, or just view access, and you can set an expiration time for this user to access the file or folder with view access only. You can also invite new people to have access to the file or folder. You can select what type of access each user will have, edit or view only. When you share a file or folder to specific people, you will receive a message from you telling them that you have shared a file or folder with them, like this one. You can prevent editors from changing access and adding new people as well. I hope you like this video. If so, please like it and share it with your friends, so more people can watch this channel and learn about its content. And don't forget to subscribe. This is Mac, and see you in my next video.